Hello friends, welcome back. My name is PK. In this video, you will learn how to create a beautiful comparative analysis dashboard in Microsoft Power BI. So as you are seeing my screen, I have created this beautiful dashboard, and in this dashboard, I have displayed the comparison of sales versus budgeted sales and comparison of the current year sales versus previous year sales. Let me put it on full screen mode. On the top, I have given a slicer to select the year or quarter or month. I have used the hierarchy slicer here. Here I have displayed the current year sales. Current year sales means whatever year has been selected. If none of the year has been selected from here or multiple year has been selected, then it will take the maximum year. So this is my current year sales. And this is budgeted sales for this year, and then this is variance between current year sales and budgeted sales. So this is the budget variance. And now here I have displayed the previous year sales and YoY sales growth. So from the previous year to this year, 32.10% is the sales growth. Now here in this chart, we have displayed current year sales by the product category. The category 3 is my top category. If I will hover here, then you can see another chart has been created, that is product level chart. And in this chart, we are able to see product buys, current year sales, previous year sales and budgeted sales. So this is the comparison of all three sales, and we are able to see the product of this category. If I will move my mouse to another category, then here we can see this is for cat 1. The product has been changed now. If I will move here, now it is displaying only 3 products which are coming under this category, which is category 4. If I will move here, then it is displaying only 2 products, because only 2 products are coming under this category. Alright friends, in this chart, let me put it on the focus mode, this chart. Now here we can see we are trying to analyze the different products between sales growth and current year sales. Here we can see this product has the highest sale as well as the highest growth from the previous year. Product 13 has the good growth, but sale is on the lower side. However, product 10 has more sale amount than the product 13, but growth is lower. If I will hover on any product, then you can see it is just displaying another chart, which is budget variance by the month. Now let me click on back button. In this chart, we have displayed the trend of current year sales, previous year sales and budgeted sales. And if you will select any category, let's say just click on this slice, then all the charts and these cards also will be changed for this category 3 only. We can select another category, then you can see the trends are getting changed. Top numbers are also getting changed. And this chart also getting changed. It is just displaying only those products now. And even if I will select any product, then I will be able to see the trend of that product only. Now in this chart, we have displayed sales trend with forecast. So you can see we have displayed all the sales available in my data, and then this is the future forecast in black and gray color. Let me put it on focus mode. Then here you can see this is the date wise sales actually. And now here I'm trying to show what will be my forecasted sales, and this forecast I have done by Power BI only. Now in this last visual, I have displayed a matrix view wherein I am displaying CY sales, PY sales, sales growth, budgeted amount or budgeted sales. And then here I have displayed the budgeted variance. We have created a hierarchy, the category and product. If I will expand this, then I'm able to see the product of category 2. If I will expand this, then I'm able to see that. Let me put it on focus mode. Let me click on this expand all down one level in the hierarchy. Then you can see it will be created like this. If you want to see the product level detail only, click on drill up, then just click on this double down arrow button. Then now this table will be changed to the product category is not there. If you will drill up, then category also will be there. So this is the comparative analysis dashboard, wherein we are trying to compare the current year sales with the previous year sales, as well as current year sales with the budgeted sales also. Now I will explain you step by step how you can create this dashboard in Microsoft Power BI. So let's start without delay. I will show you the data which I have used. So I have some sample data here in the Excel. You can see this is the budget data, wherein I have the budgeted amount or budgeted sales, and then I have the product ID, and here I have the month. So this is start of the month. That means the budgeted sales data we have month by month, not on the daily basis. Now I'll show you the sales data. In the sales data we have date. This is day wise data. Then we have the product ID and the sales amount. On the next tab we have the product master, wherein we have displayed the product ID, product name and the category name of the product. This is the sample data, friends. You can change it with your data. Now I will tell you how can you create this in Microsoft Power BI. So let me go to the Power BI. I have opened the Power BI untitled here, you can see. So this is the blank Power BI file. Now I'll go to the home, then I'll go to the get data, and from here I'll go to the Excel, and we will choose this Excel file. This is the Excel file which I was displaying you. So let me open this. Okay, it is saying it is in use, so I have already opened it. Let me close this. Now select this, click on open. So these are the three worksheets in that Excel file. The first one is the budget, then second is the product master, then third is the sales. Okay, so all preview looks fine. So just check all three and just directly load this. We don't need to go to the Power Query. So let's load this directly. Alright, so all three tables have been loaded, you can see here. Now I will create a date dimension table or the calendar table. So I'll go to the table view and let's go to the calculation, and here I will create new table. Put the name of this table as calendar or date dimension. So let's put here date dimension, and then here I will use calendar auto function. Automatically it will take the relevant dates from my data model and just press enter. You can see it is taking the all dates. Now I will add few columns here as per my requirement. So let's add new column, and this column name I'll put here year, and I will use here date dimension date, this one, and then here I will select year dot year. Press enter, it will give you year. Now add another column, table tools, new column, and here I will put this time month, and for month we will use date dimension dot month. Press enter. Then we will take the quarter also. So what I will do, I'll create new column again, then I will use here quarter, and we will use date dimension date dot quarter, this one, quarter, not quarter number, take quarter. So it will show you the text also, QTR space 1. Alright, so for now let's keep it as it is and just go to the model view. Here in the model view, you can see it has created some automatic relationship with the product master. So product master is our dimension table and these two are fact table. Now it has connected the product master on the base of product ID, and similarly here it has connected with the product ID. Now let's put another dimension table which is date dimension to fit this so that it could be visible to you. Now I will connect this date with this date, and similarly this date with month. So month, friends, I have displayed month is start of the month, so ultimately it's a date. So let me show you once again. Go to this view, and here we have budget table. In the budget we have the month, and you can see month is nothing but this is the start date of the month. So ultimately it's a date. Alright, so we will connect it with the date. Alright, now we will hide few columns. So the columns we will hide in the budget, We don't want to show now the month and product ID in the report view. So what we can do, right click here and hide in report view. Similarly, this column also. And in the product master, we will not show the product ID. In the sales, we will not show the date, because date we will take from the date dimension, and we will not show the product ID also. Alright, now let me go to the report view. And here you can see in this table only budgeted amount is visible and date dimension is completely visible. In the product master we have category and product name. Then in the sales we have only sales amount. Alright, now we will start our visualization. Before we start the visualization, to create this view, what I have done, I have taken the support of PowerPoint presentation. In the PowerPoint presentation, I have created this picture, you can see, using the PowerPoint shapes. Let me show you quickly how can you create this. Let me add new slide and then let's delete these. What I have done, I have taken a rectangle first, go to the insert, then go to the shapes and take this rectangle and just drag this rectangle here like this. And for this rectangle, I have taken the shape outline as no outline and shape fill, I have taken the dark blue color. So let's take this one. Then I have inserted another rectangle, but this time I have taken this rectangle which is rounded corner rectangle and I have dragged the rectangle like this, pick this yellow handle and move slightly like this, and shape outline I have taken no outline, shape fill I have taken light gray, this one. Then we can insert another rectangle. Go to the shape, and but this time we have taken this rectangle which is top corners rounded, and just click here and change the size like this and keep this here slightly smaller. Then pick this yellow handle, move to the left side, just keep this here. So we have adjusted this. Then just go to the shape style and from here we have taken this color. And then go to the shape outline again and say no outline. The same thing we have done here. If you will see, you can adjust the width of both rectangle accordingly. You can put the name also using the text box, whatever dashboard name you want to put. If you want to add any logo of your client or company, you can add that also. Once you have created all the things, then simply select any shape, press Ctrl A to select all and then right click and make them group. And once you have created the group, simply right click, go to the save picture, then you can save the picture as PNG or JPEG. So I have saved here three pictures. I'll tell you about two more pictures also. For now, I have saved this BG1, which is background one. And once you have saved this picture, then go to your Power BI. And this is our first phase. And then go to the visualization. First, don't import any visualization here. Just go to the format. So this is the format for page. So we will go to the page background, then we will add the image here. We will select BG1, then transparency we will select 0. Then we will go to the image fit and here we will choose fit. So you can see our page will look like this, and this is simple page and we have not created any visual. Once you have loaded the background image on the page, then you can start your visualization. So before starting the visualization, we need to create few measures. So measures we will create, like here we have displayed CY sales, budgeted variance, PY sales and YOY sales growth. So we will create these measures also. So what I will do, I'll go to sales table. So let's create measures in the sales table. So right click here, go to the new measure. We will add the first measure as, let's say, CY sales, current year sales. And then here we will take first a variable bear CY equal to, and we will use max year, and here we will take date dimension year. We are using the CY because if in the slicer you have not selected any year, then automatically it will take latest year. So that's why we are using this max function. Then we will use here return, and we will use calculate sum of sales. So we will take sales amount, this one, In the filter, we will put date dimension year, this one equal to CY. So we have already created the relationship between date dimension and sales. So it can, date dimension can filter the sales table. So we will use this one, press enter. So this is our first measure. Now we will add another measure. So you can go to the measure tool and add new measure here. And here we will create the PY sales. In the PY sales, we will simply use calculate and CY sales, this one. And we will use the same period last year. And here we will use date column of date dimension, this one. So it will take the same period of last year, whatever you are taking in CY sales, it will take the same period of the last year. Press enter. Now let's create another measure here. Take new measure. And this time we will take YOY sales growth percentage. And then here we will use divide function, divide. And we will divide the difference of current year and previous year. That will be our numerator, and we will divide it by previous year. So I will use here CY sales, this measure, minus PY sales, this measure, and we will divide it by PY sales. That will be our growth from the last year. And alternate result, we will use blank. So in case of any error, or if this value is zero, then divide will return some error. So that's why we are using this alternate result will return blank. Press enter. Now let's create the measure for budget also. So let's take new measure here and budget amount or budgeted sales. And we can use this for CY so that the comparison should not be changed. So I'll use here where CY equal to max year return, and we will use the calculate sum of budgeted amount, this one. And then here we will use year equal to CY. All right, and just press enter. Now we will create another measure to display the variance of budgeted sales and the current year sales. So create new measure and take the budget variance. And here we will use simple divide function again. And we will take CY sales minus budgeted sales and divide by budgeted sales, and alternate result we will take blank. In the numerator, we are taking the difference between current year sales and the budgeted sales and dividing it by the budgeted sales to get the variance percentage. Alright, now let's change for the budgeted variance percentage as percentage. Just click here. And similarly for YOY sales growth percentage, just click here on the percentage. Now we will start our visualization. So first we will create few cards. So just go to the visualization pane and just take this card, make it slightly smaller like this. And here drag first CY sales, this one. So you can see the current year sales is here. And let me format this. So just go to the format and then go to the borders and just on the border, and let's take the black border but put some radius around 5 point. Okay, so now make a copy of this and paste the second card we will create for PY sale, or you can create for budgeted sales also. So let's create for budgeted sales. So this is our budgeted sales. Now copy and paste the next card we will display for budget variance. So let's take for the budget variance. This is budget variance. Copy and paste. And this time we will create another card for PY sales. And copy and paste. And this time we will display here YOY sales growth. Alright, so we have created all 5 cards. We will change the width of the card so that all the cards could be adjusted in one line. Select all the cards and make them group. So just go to the format and make them group. And now change the size. Now we have the proper space. Select all the cards and go to the format, align them top. and then distribute horizontally. Okay, now we will put some conditional formatting on budget variance and YOY sales growth. If the variance is in negative, we will display in red, or it is in positive, we will display the text color in green. Similarly here YOY sales growth also. So we will choose the color code for red and green. You can use the colorhex.com, and from here I will choose this color for red, let's say. So let's copy this color code, don't copy this hex, and then just select this budget variance card, then go to the format and then go to the data label, and here you can see the data label color is black. Just click on this FX button, which is for conditional formatting. Click here. It will open this box. And here, just select the rule. In the rule, we will take first is greater than or equal to and put here 0. If that value is greater than or equal to 0 and less than, just remove the 0 from here. That is the maximum. Automatically, it will take maximum. And then go to the color and custom color and just paste that color here. This is for red, ideally it should be for green. So let me copy the code for green. Let's copy this code. Let's change it. So this is for green. Add a new rule, and in this rule we will take again is greater than or equal to, and we will take here minimum. So don't type any value here, automatically it will take minimum. Number is less than, let's put here 0, automatically it is taking, and here we will select the red. We can take from the recent color also. Click on OK. You can see the color has been changed, and same thing we will repeat for YOY also. So what I will do, I'll select only this card, go to the format painter and just click here. Now I will add a slicer, and in this slicer from the date dimension I will put year first. Then I can put the quarter, and then I can put the month also. So here we can see all the year, quarter and months are available. If I will expand, then you can see it will display the quarter. If I will expand any quarter, it will display the month also. You can select entire year also. Now you can see the numbers are getting changed and the color also getting changed. Alright friends, now what I will do, I'll change this slicer into drop down. So just click on this small arrow and select the drop down from here. I'll go to the format, and from here first I will remove the headers. We don't need the headers. And I will remove the background also. For item, I will keep the white background. So select the white background and just put this slicer here. Alright, so you can select any year. So let's select 2019 because we have the complete data of 2019. Now we will create our other visuals also. So let me see the dashboard. Here we have displayed the CY sales by category. So let's create this one. I will create this donut from here. And in this donut, we will take the category from the product master. So let's take the category. And then let's take the CY sales in the values. You can see this chart is ready. Now we will make little formatting. So I'll go to the format, and here I will go to the title first. In the title, I will take the background color, let's say this dark blue, and font color I will take white, and font family I will take this one. Then I will go to the border, and we will take the border, and radius we will take around 10. So our chart will look like this. Now we will create the another chart. And the next chart we will create for this scatter chart for CY sales and YOY growth by the product. So I'll go to the this scatter chart, click here, and we will create this chart here. And here we will take the CY sales on Y axis, then we will take the YOY sales growth on X axis, and in detailed we will take the product name. Just put the product names here, and we can do the same formatting whatever we have done here. So I will select this one, go to the format painter and just click here. The same formatting will be applied. You can change the chart title as per your requirement. We will do some other formatting also in this chart. So I'll go to the format, and then we'll go to the data color. And here you can see the data color is blue. We can put the condition formatting here, so just go to the FX, and here we will use the color scale. For the lower one we will take this red, and for the higher one we will take this green. We can use the diverging also. You can select some yellow color here, this one, but we will not create it on the base of CY sales. We will create it on the base of YoY sales growth. Click on OK. Then you can see the color has been changed. If you want to show the legend of this color, you can display. Otherwise you can go to the legend and off the legend. Now you can see the bubble size is pretty much small. So what we will do, I'll go to the shape and bubble size is minus 10. Let's put it 10 or 15. Then it is quite big now. If you want to display the product name, so which product is this one, when you will hover it will be displayed. If you want to display default, then you can on this category name. Now let me put it on focus mode. You can see it will look like this. If you want to make these grid lines as solid, you can go to the x-axis first and just scroll it down and just go to the grid lines. You can take little darker color also. Let's take this one. In place of dotted, let's take this solid. Do the same thing for the y-axis also. Let's take little darker color this one. In place of dotted, let's take solid. Then our chart will look like this. Alright, so let's create the third chart now. And to create the third chart, this is the area chart by CY, PY and budgeted sales by month. So let's copy this chart. And let's paste this here. Change this visualization as this area chart, this one. Remove the category from here and we will take month, this month. Then we will display the CY sales, PY sales and budgeted sales, this one. So we have displayed all three sales here like this. But if you will see, let me put it on focus mode. If you will see, order of the month is not correct, so we will sort it by month. So we will sort it by month and let's keep it in ascending order, this one. You can see the month is sorted in ascending order because it's a tax order is not correct. April, August, December, Feb, it is according to the alphabets. So what we will do, we will go to the data and we will go to the date dimension table, this one. We will add another column here, add a new column. And this column name we will keep month number, and here we will use date. Then let's take the month number, this one. Now select this month column and then sort this month column by month number. Just click here. That's it. Now go to the report view and just put it on focus mode. You can see the order automatically has been changed for months. Alright, you can make the chart title slightly smaller also because it is not fit properly. So let's take the size around 13 or 12. Similarly here, let's take 12 and here also. Now we will create another chart. So let's copy this chart and paste this here, and here we will create another chart. And that chart for sales trend with forecast. So what I will do here, I'll use date in place of month. So let's take the date and remove this hierarchy. So just take only date. So this is the date and we will keep only CY sales here. Now we will add, just go to this analytics and we will add the forecast here. So you can see the forecast is not visible, so go to the line chart. We will create the line chart here. Now the forecast is visible here, so add the forecast, and forecast we will display for next 1 year. So in the points, take the year and add 1 year here. Then seasonality, it is taking auto, so let me click on apply. You can see it is not taking the proper seasonality here. So what I will do, I'll put these seasonality points at 365 for 1 year seasonality, apply, then our chart will look like this. Now since this chart is connected with this slicer, if I will remove, then you can see it will look like this. So what we will do, we will edit the introduction from this. So to edit the introduction, just select the slicer, go to the format and click on edit introduction, and here just click on this none. So it will not filter out now. Even if I will select, let's say 2019, then all the charts and other visuals will be filtered accordingly, but this chart will not be filtered. Okay. Now we will create this table. To create this table, we will use the matrix. So this is a matrix. So just go to the matrix. This is matrix, and change the size like this. In this matrix, first we will take the rows. In the rows, we will take category. Then we will take product. And then we will display here in the values C by sales, P by sales, then BYU by sales growth. Then we will display here budgeted sales and budgeted variance also. Now we will format this properly. So I'll go to the format. From here, first we will choose the style. So you can choose any style from here. Let me choose minimal. So this is the minimal style. Then I'll go to the column headers and we will choose some background. So let's take this blue background, and font color we will take white, and make this bold also. So let's take font name as this one. So it will be a little bold now. Let's go to the row header. We don't want to see the step layout. When we will expand this, then it will show the product here. We want to see the product in next column. So just stop this. Now if I will expand, then it will show the new column of the product. All right. Now let's go to the subtotal, and in the subtotal, what we will do, we will change the background color little gray, this one. So let me put it on focus mode, so that it could be visible to you properly. If I will expand, then it will show the subtotals in gray colors. So it will be easy to identify. Or if I will click here, then you can see the subtotals are in gray color. But the total is still, the background is white. So what we will do, for the grand total, we will take little dark background. So let's take this gray. Okay. So now our matrix will look like this. Now these numbers, C by sales, P by sales and budgeted sales number, are quite big. They might not be readable properly. So what I will do, I'll convert them into millions. So I'll show the numbers in millions. So I'll go to the field formatting here. You can see the C by sales is default selected here. Then I'll go to the display unit and I will select in millions. You can see the C by sales is in millions now. Similarly for P by sales, I'll display in millions. Then this budgeted sales also I'll show in millions. Alright. Now wherever the growth is positive, we will show up arrow in green color using the conditional formatting, and budgeted variance is also positive, then show the up arrow in green. Otherwise we will display red arrow in down. So we will use the conditional formatting. Go to the conditional formatting. First, let's choose on which field do you want to put the conditional formatting. So let's put it on YoY sales growth. Select the YoY sales growth, then icons. Default, it is taking the icons automatically, but don't take it as default. So go to the advanced control. And here, what we will do, first, in place of percentage, just select the numbers. Let's select number here, number here, number here. Okay. And let's put the first rule as if is greater than, not equal to, let's take is greater than 0 and is less than, just delete this number, then automatically it will take maximum. Then it should display the green arrow, up arrow. So you can take this arrow, or let's take this arrow also. And the second we will take when is 0. When the growth is 0, then it should display some this icon, yellow dash. And now this time I will take is greater than or equal to minimum number. So delete this and is less than 0. Then it will display this red down triangle. Click on OK. Here you can see the YoY growth is all in positive, so it is displaying up green arrow. Same thing we will repeat for budget variance also. So let's select here budget variance under the condition formatting. Then on this icons, automatically it will take some icons, but go to the advanced control. So what I will do first, in place of percentage we'll take number. Now here I will select is greater than 0, less than maximum. So just delete this, automatically it will take maximum. Select here this green, and this time we will select age and put here 0. If it is 0, then yellow dash this one. If it is greater than or equal to minimum number and less than 0, then we will take this red down triangle. Okay. Then here you can see wherever it is negative, it is taking down arrow. For positive, it is taking green arrow. Alright, so our table is also ready. Now you can put the formatting similarly like this. So I'll go to the formats and border on, and radius you can put around 10. Alright, so our table view is also ready. Now you can see both view, or you can drill up, then it will show the category label view. You can click on this double arrow, then it will show the next label, which is product label view, or you can see both together using this button, then it will show category and product label view. Dashboard is almost ready. Few things we have to change. Let's say if I will click on this product, then you can see the cross filter is also working, but it is highlighting only. I want to filter it out completely. So what I will do, I'll select this visual, go to the format, edit introduction, and I will click on this filter part. So you can see it is filtering properly. Similarly, I will click here and I will filter it out properly from here also. Alright, so now it is filtering properly. From here, if I will select, it is also filtering properly. And you can filter out from the table also. Let's select any product, it will display only that product, and for category also. Okay, now we will put the tooltip. Like here I have put the tooltip. If I will hover here, then it will display this product wise tooltip, and if I will hover here, then it will display the budget variance by month. So how we can create these tooltips? I will add a new page. So let's rename this page as dashboard. This is the dashboard page. And then here I will put the name as, this will be my product tooltip. I'll go to the page and page information, and just on this tooltip here. And we will change the page size also. Page size, you can choose the page size tooltip from here if you want to take it default. But I want to take the size like this, not the tooltip size. So I will use the custom size here. So let's use the custom size. In the custom size, we can take the width around, let's say 250, and height around 350. All right. Then I'll go to the PowerPoint, and you can create the visual also if required. Otherwise, you can create directly without using the background also. But here I have used the background. So this is the background. This is simple background. Like here I have created. These are the rectangles which I have used. And I have created another tooltip page, so for that I have created this another background, and I have saved this background here also. You can see this is the simple background using the PPT. These background we will use in PowerPoint now. So let's go to the page background here, add image, and just go to the that folder and take the background 2 for this one. Transparency let's take 0. Then we will fit this properly, so use fit, and here we will create the chart by product. So I'll add this chart, cluster bar chart, keep this chart here, then add the product on the axis, and in the values we will take CY sales, PY sales, and budgeted sales also. We will not take the title here, so let's off the title from the formatting. We will remove this x-axis also. Just remove the x-axis and add the data labels here. And we can see the product names are not properly visible, and the title, we don't need the title for the axis. So go to the Y axis and first of all maximize the size. So let's take the 50%, then product name are properly visible. Off the title, similarly go to the X axis and just off the title. Alright, we will change some colors also. Go to the data color. For the CY sales, let's take little darker blue, this one. For PY sales, little light blue. And for budgeted sales, little more lighter blue, this one. Alright, now I'll go to the dashboard. I'll go to this chart and then select this chart, go to the format, and then I'll go to the tooltip. And here you can see the report page is selected. Now the page is auto. So select the page here, product tooltip. If I will hover here, you can see it is displaying the product tooltip. Alright. Similarly, I'll create another page. I'll make the duplicate of this page. Right click and duplicate page. And here we will change the page size first. So go to the page size and let's take this time width as 350 and height as around 200. In place of this chart, we will use the column chart now. So let's take this cluster column chart. In place of product name, we will use the month name. So let's take the month here and remove the product from here. And we will not display here the CY sales, PY sales. We will display the budget variance and remove this one also. So it is taking only budget variance. We will go to the data color and the color we will take dynamically. So I'll click on this conditional formatting to choose the color and I'll go to the rule. And here I will select the budget variance. You can search by the variance. Select the budget variance, and when it is greater than or equal to 0 number and less than, let's take here maximum number, then we will select this green color, add new rule. If it is greater than or equal to minimum number and less than 0, then we will select this red color. Click on OK. So it will display the red or green color. Rename this is, let's say, trend tooltip. Then go to dashboard, select this chart and go to the format tooltip and add this trend tooltip here. If I will hover, then you can see it is displaying me, but we can put the title here so that it can be easy to understand. So just add the chart title, go to the title, it is displaying the budget variance by month. Make it in the center and slightly smaller. Alright, so it's working perfectly. If you want to add the tooltip here also, you can add that here also. So just go to the visualization and tooltip, add the tooltip here and select the trend tooltip. Then you can see it is displaying the tooltip. Alright, so it's working perfectly. Now we can save this, save as, and let's save it as comparative analysis dashboard, and let me rename this as with new because I have already published this dashboard. So save this. Now I will publish this dashboard. So just go to the home and publish this. Make sure you have logged in with your ID and save. Then you can select the workspace, in which workspace you want to publish this, the my workspace, or you can select or any other workspace also, and it is published successfully. You can just click here to open that. So this is the dashboard we just have published. It's looking beautiful. Alright friends, so friends, that is how you can create this comparative analysis dashboard. You can publish this to the Power BI services. I hope you have enjoyed this video. Friends, if you like this video, please hit the like button and please subscribe my channel to get the regular update of my videos. Thank you so much for watching.